Hello everyone, welcome to the video series of the subject Object Oriented Programming using Java. Myself Hemali Shah, I am working as Assistant Professor in LJ Institute of Engineering and Technology. Now in this video lecture I am going to cover about the Java networking and inet address class of this networking API. Now this topic is a particular part of unit number 7, collection classes and networking. Now we have already done with the first part, this collection classes, in previous video lecture, and I'm going to cover this part 2, this is networking, in this particular video. So what kind of application you can build by using this Java networking? What is the basic concept of Java networking? This I'm going to cover, and inet address class I'm going to cover. Now Java networking basically provides the connection between more than one computing device. This all works together in that they all can share the data, they can exchange the data between the multiple devices and multiple computers. Here you must need to run your Java program on more than one devices. This both the devices will communicate by using our Java application, right? So here this Java socket programming available. Here this socket programming is available with TCP. Connection oriented based socket programming is also available, and UDP connection less based socket programming is also available. So by using this two socket programming mechanism, you can exchange the data between the more than one computing devices, right? Now this API which provides the classes and interfaces that provides this Java networking based facility is java.net. This java.net is a basically package having the classes and interfaces, right, that provides a networking kind of facility. Now which kind of application you can build? So here the daytime server you can build. Some client can receive the real time from some application. Such a application you can create by using the daytime server mechanism. You can create the chatting based application, any client server based application where clients want some requests and wants to use some services provided by server. At that time you can implement the server that actually replies the requested outputs by performing the operation on the server, and client actually uses the services provided by the server. So such a client server based application you can build using the Java networking API. Right. Say for the example, one client wants to convert the string into uppercase, and you are making some function at the server side that actually receives the string and convert your received string into uppercase and generate the reply, and client can get the reply from the server. So such a big app, you can create such a big functions at the server side also, and client actually request for that particular service and server replies for that particular service. Such a services you can build on the server side by using the socket programming. Now networking games basically uses this socket programming concept and networking Java API. So in this case, this Java gaming application basically exchange the messages between the multiple applications which runs on the multiple devices. So such a network based game you can create by using Java networking API. Now what are the network terminology that I will use in the programming? First of all, IP address. IP address is basically a unique number assigned to node, or we can say per computer or per computing device which you are using inside your program. All must have one IP address. This IP address you must know to communicate with the node available in your networking program, right? IP address, example of IP address, you are already knowing 192.168.3.11. this particular 32-bit IP address we are using to identify particular computer in a network. Port number basically used to identify particular application available in a network device. Say for the example, your particular mobile is available and that wants to communicate with another mobile. In that case, your particular mobile also running multiple internet based applications. So for which application you wants to send the data, So each and every application actually uses some unique number. That unique number basically specifies I want to communicate with this particular application. So this is basically port number basically identifies the application which running on the particular device that you are going to connect by using the IP address, right? So basically IP address locate the particular computer in your network, and this port number basically locate the application that is running on that particular node, right? So this is the mechanism that we have to use when we make the TCP network programming applications. Now what is protocol? So protocol basically set of rules that followed for the communication purpose. So when you are sending and receiving the data, some of the rules must be followed, and that rules must be satisfied when your data travels from one node to another node. So this rules basically called as a protocol. Now at the transport layer, we are having two types of protocols, TCP and UDP. TCP is basically connection oriented protocol that provides the reliable data delivery, and this connection less protocol is UDP, user datagram protocol, that basically provides the unreliable delivery, right? So here this TCP basically uses three-way handshaking. If client and server both having the connection established, then and only then it sends and receives the data. While in connectionless mechanism UDP, it never establishes the connection, so that your all the data that you are sending in form of packets all will follow some different path. While in connection oriented TCP program, your all the data always follow some same path when you are sending from the sender node to receiving node. So this is the basic mechanism and difference between TCP and UDP. So here in the Java networking API, the classes are available. Some of the classes provide the connection oriented data send receive mechanism, and some of the classes provides the connection less data exchange mechanism, right? So based on the requirement of your application, you should use that particular classes in your program. Now socket, what is socket? So when you establish the connections, when you want to send some data, when you want to receive some data, it actually occupies one port in your node. So this socket is basically endpoint between the two way communication. So when you are establishing the connection, when you are sending the data and receiving the data, both things sending and receive should be done by using some socket. So it basically two-way communication endpoint that you can specify by using this socket, right? Now let's move forward. So the classes that I'm going to cover, and these classes are available in this java.net API. So first class is inet address. So I'm only covering the inet address class in this video lecture. So inet address class, let's focus on the network API. For that, I'm only opening this Java documentation over here. So this is the Java documentation. Let me move in java.net. Java.net package, right? This java.net package having the class inet address. This is the class. Now, what is the use of this inet address class? This inet address class use for that represent your IP address in form of objects. So by using this object of this class, you can fetch the local machine IP address, you can convert the domain name to IP address, your domain name to IP address, and from the IP address you can get the domain name also. So it is also called the host name. So from IP to host name and host name to IP conversion, we are using the inet address class, right? So here this all are the functions which are available in this inet address class. First of all, you equals basically map the two objects of inet address are basically used to compare to inet address class. Get address basically returns your IP address in form of byte array. Now these two are the non-static function. Now see this three static function. This four static function: get by address, get by address, get by name. These all are the static function that you can use only by using the INET address class name. GetByName basically converts your host name to INET address object, and the return type is also available as an INET address. So from the host name you can get the object of INET address, and this is a static function, so you can call only by using the class name without object of INET address class, right? Now such that getLocalhost is a function. This getLocalhost returns the INET address object, and it is also a static function, so you can call this function directly without object, right? So this basically returns the address of a local host, and this getHost by name and getAll by name returns the array of the INET address. These two having the same name, getAll, same mechanism, it returns the multiple IP address from the host name and it returns the single IP address from the host name. So I'm only focusing on the important methods. These all are the static function, and here this is a non-static function. Get host name returns the string, and this get host address, this get host address returns the string, it returns the IP address, and it returns the fully qualified domain name of from the IP address, right? So here these functions you can use when here it returns the get host name. So this function you can use if you have the INET address object. Now this INET address object having all the constructors private, so you cannot create the object of INET address. So we can only use the static functions, and we can get the reference variable that is written by this all the functions, and after getting the reference of INET address we can call the non-static function. So keep in mind, we cannot create the object by using the new keyword, right? So that's why we have to use only static function in our program. So let's focus on the program first. So here this is the example that I am going to perform by using the INET address class, right? So first of all, you have to perform this print host name and numeric IP address of the machine on which you are executing your application. This you can do by using the INET address class only. And another example, you have to do the print IP address and host name of www.google.com by using the INET address class. Now to perform this particular application, I'm opening this NetBeans window. So here this is the NetBeans. Now I'm creating a new project. I'm creating a new project, Java application, and giving the name networking demo. Right now create the class INET address demo. Don't use only INET address, INET address demo program, right? So here in this program, what is the aim of the program? To print the IP address and host the name of local machine. First of all, import this java.net.star. I'm only using INET address class. You can specify the only INET address over here also. Now PSVM tab. Now inside this, you cannot create the object of INET address, right? So what is the function that returns the IP address of local machine? The local host, right? So INET address class having one static function getLocalhost. This getLocalhost basically returns the, what is the return type? See here, the return type is INET address. So it basically returns the IP address of local machine in form of object of INET address. So you can store this local IP of return value into LIP object, right? See here, this all throwing the throws the unknown host exception, and this is a checked exception class. See here, these all are the child classes of exception. So here you have to mention as a surrounded tri-catch block like this, or you can mention as a throws list, right? So here I am handling it and I am printing this object in catch, right? Now let's move to print the IP host name of local machine. So how to print the host name? The function that we should call is get host name, right? But this get host name is a non-static function, so you must have the object of this inet address class. So this LIP is a object written by this get local host function. So now you have non-null object. Now you can call this function get host name, right? This basically returns the host name of local machine, and this is the function that actually returns the numerical IP address, get host address in form of string. So this address you can print like this, right? So I'm going to run this program. See here, this is my host name and this is the host address of my machine. This 192.168.103.128, right? So this is the IP address of the local machine on which I am running my program. If I am going to execute this program on your computer, then the output will be different because it returns the IP address of current running machine, local machine's IP address. So this is the code that you can use to print the IP address of local machine, right? Now I am going to print the second aim that prints IP of google.com, right? Now to run this program, you must have the internet connection. So first of all, you have to connect your computer with the internet, then and only then you should run this program. Otherwise, it only prints the error unknown host exception, right? So you don't need to worry about it. You will not get the output. Now how to get the host name from the how to get the IP address from the host name? The function name is inet address is a class inet address dot get by name. Get my name is a function that actually accept the parameter as a host name. So I am giving the host name google.com. This is the host name I am giving, and this get by name function returns the object of inet address, right? So you can use the object name Google IP address. So this is a static function, that's why we can call this function. I have already told you, you cannot create the object of inet address class. See, this is the class having the constructor, but this constructor is a private, non-public. Here there is no public keyword is written over here, right? Inet address class, let me move in the inet address first. This inet address class having non-public constructor. See here, this is not public keyword is written, right? That's why you cannot create the object of inet address by using the new, because this class is available inside the net package. So outside package you can only create the object of by using the constructor having the written keyword public. Public access specifier is written. So don't create this object of inet address by using the new operator, right? Only use the static function and that returns the actual object. So by using that return object, you can access the functions that all are non-static. So now you can call this functions, this host name you can print and IP address you can print with the object GIP, right? GIP.getName and GIP.getHostName. And I execute this program like this. Here I am getting unknown host exception because there is no internet, but I can access the intranet machine. And LJIET is host name of the LJ server. So I am getting this IP address of LJ servers 192.168.100.98. right? So this is the server address I am getting. So here you can use any any host name, domain name, www.facebook.com, whatsapp.com, like the domain which are exist on the internet, that domain you can use over here. And just connect your computer in an internet and you can access the IP address of any machine, right? So you have to tell me the IP address of Google when and execute this program and see the IP address of Google. Now you can also use the get all by name function, and it actually returns the inet address objects array. So when you are using get all by name, get all by name, it actually returns the inet address array. So you can mention the IPs like this, and by using the for each loop you can mention you can view all the host names and IP address that is written inside this array, right? So for by using for each loop, and inside this for each loop you can use this IP object, and you can print all the IPs written by this particular domain name. So some of the domain have more than one IPs that you can return or that you can get by calling the function get all by name, right? So hope you people are clear with the concept, all these concepts that I have covered in this video lecture. So here I am moving in the presentation. So thank you for watching this video. Thank you all of you.